A very important observation to do here is that without the resource constraint here, so if I remove that one from the problem, then I have a very easy problem, which is the shortest path problem that you can solve with Dijkstra algorithm, for instance, that you know already very well. Okay, and we will use this observation as the main driver to design an approach for finding a good lower bound and good solution to that problem. Okay, it's the fact that if we remove this very nasty constraint, then the problem is easy. Okay, it's a well-known shortest path problem. Okay, I will slightly modify my problem now. Okay, I will take this constraint. I will take this constraint here and I will add it into my objective function. Okay, I add it to my objective function, but I will keep it inside the problem. So it will stay in the problem, but I will add it there. And I will take the left hand side minus, sorry, the right hand side here minus the left hand side. Okay, or the left hand side minus the right hand side. So I will take it like this. And as you can see here, because this is less than this, do you think that this term is positive or is it negative? Okay, knowing that lambda must be large or equal to zero. Okay, so if we take lambda, okay, that is an additional parameter to that problem that you should consider as a variable as well, or a fixed value, whatever. But anyway, it's a positive value. If you do this minus this, knowing that you have this constraint, clearly this is less than zero, right? Okay, it's less or equal to than zero. Okay, and since this is larger or equal to zero, the total amount here that you will add will also be less or equal to zero. Okay, so it means that in the worst case, you will add zero, and for every other cases, you will remove some value from this objective function. Okay, so by making this transformation, what I have here is a lower bound on my initial problem. Okay, this is an objective value, assuming that all the rest stays the same, it's an objective value that can only be lower than the objective value of my initial problem. Okay, so you don't know yet why I'm doing this, but at this point you should realize that I'm removing possibly something to my objective function, but I'm not adding something positive to it. I can only decrease my objective function. Okay, so this is this a lower bound on my initial problem. Okay, this transform problem is a lower bound on the initial problem. Okay, I continue my transformation here. And now I keep my objective function as it was, but I will also remove this capacity constraint. Okay, I'm removing this capacity constraint. And my question for you is, do you think that the optimum value to that problem is also a lower bound compared to the previous one? Okay, is it also a lower bound? And to understand why it's also a lower bound, okay, you should consider the very general case here where you have a minimization problem over a feasible region. Okay, this is your feasible region. Okay, so you want to minimize an objective value, and the solution that you need to find is inside this specific set that I have represented here. Okay, so now if you decide to remove some of the constraint of your problem, the feasible region can only be larger. Okay, for instance, it will be this. Okay, but it will at least enclose the previous feasible region. Okay, this is exactly what I did here. Okay, I have removed the constraint of my problem, so my feasible region can only become a superset of the previous one, which means that the objective function, if I'm minimizing something over this feasible region, can only be lower, it cannot be larger. Okay, so if I remove this constraint, it means that it's also a lower bound on the previous lower bound. Okay, it cannot increase, it will also be a lower bound here. So this will also be a lower bound on the rest on the constraint short space problem as well. Okay. Now I will do a little bit of manipulation of the formula of the objective function here. Okay. And I will factorize xij. Okay, because you see that xij here is represented here and here. Okay, you find it here and here. If I'm factorizing here it, okay, I can write my objective function into a completely equivalent form as this. Okay, this is the new transform objective function here. And what is nice here is that if lambda is fixed, okay, for a given value of lambda, okay, this is fixed, right? And so if this is fixed, you cannot really act on it. If lambda is fixed, you cannot act on it. It will be considered as a constant, okay? And so the problem that you need to solve here is a shortest path problem, okay? Because I don't take this into account, a shortest path problem, but the weight of the edges are a little bit different, okay? I'm not taking only Cij into account here. I'm taking into account as the weight on my transform problem, Cij plus lambda Tij, okay? And so for a given value of lambda, you transform the weight of the edges like this one, okay? And this is the only weight that you need to take into account. And then you have a shortest path problem, okay? But your goal is to find the best lower bound as possible. And this lower bound, as you can see, is also dependent of the value lambda. Okay, so your goal, if you want to solve a minimization problem, is to find the tightest possible lower bound. So you want to find a good lower bound, a lower bound that is quite high. You want to find the largest possible lower bound. And for that, you want to maximize the minimum over lambda. Okay, you want to maximize it. And this will give you the strongest possible lower bound. But first, let's consider one example here. Okay, so if I take lambda is equal to 2, I will transform every edge weight as this, okay? And so this will be 1 plus 2 times 10, right? And so this will be 21, okay? Exactly. So I'm transforming my set of coordinates Cij, Tij into a unique weight. Let's call it Wij, which is the weight that I will use here to compute my lower bound. I find this lower bound. I find the shortest path on this graph, which is this one. So I find the shortest path, okay? And the total weight of this shortest path here will be this part of the objective function, okay, which is 16 plus 5 plus 8 plus 6. Okay, which is 35. And then I also need to remove minus lambda t, so minus 2 times t, which was my capacity constraint. And so my lower bound here is 15. Okay, 15 is the is one possible lower bound here, assuming that lambda is fixed. And so for any value of lambda, you will find a lower bound. And if you want to find the strongest lower bound, you need to maximize, to discover the lambda that will maximize this lower bound. Okay. And so to get the best possible lower bound, what we want to maximize is maximize over lambda, this formula that is lambda dependent, which was represented here. Okay. You want to find the lambda that will maximize this minimization problem. Okay, this will be the best possible lower bound. And so we have a double problem here. We want to find the best lambda, and we want to find the path that is the best lower bound, assuming this lambda is fixed. And this one is given by the shortest path problem in these transformed coordinates. Okay, Cij minus lambda Tij. And so let's summarize everything here in the problem. We have L star, which is the best Lagrangian relaxation lower bound, is the one of discovering the maximum over lambda of this minimization problem here, okay? And lambda should be what we call the Lagrangian multiplier, and it should be larger or equal to zero here, okay? And so again, for a given value of lambda, the lower bound can easily compute it with the standard shortest path problem. And this problem is also called the Lagrangian dual. Okay, it's quite interesting to know it as well.